It's me, Mario!
Power Up Mushrooms, One Up Mushrooms, Bowser, Goomba, Toad. We have Mario, Luigi, Princess Toadstool, Bullet Bills, Chomp Chomps, and everyone else. This is Mario Mondays. I am Retro Flea. I'm going to be taking you around the Mario universe every single Monday in a new episode. So, as Mario would have said, here we go!
So, since the majority of the population, or the gaming population, thinks that Super Mario Bros. Is the first Mario game out there, I'm gonna start with this, and then I'm gonna move back and forward in history as I please. Because this is a big, huge, humongous topic about Mario. So, anyway, Super Mario Bros. Was released in 1985, so that makes it almost 30 years old. So, and it was designed by the legendary video game designer Shigeru Miyamoto, which has also made Donkey Kong, Zelda, Popeye, and all those games. So here's a little brief information about Mario. So Mario debuted as Jumpman in the arcade game Donkey Kong on July 9th, 1981. So that's my year when I was born. And he is shown as a carpenter that has a pet ape. And the carpenter mistreats the ape, so Donkey Kong escapes and kidnaps Jumpman's girlfriend, originally known as the Lady, but she was later named Pauline. So the player must take the role of Jumpman and rescue the girl. The character was later renamed Mario in the 1982 arcade game Donkey Kong Jr., the only game in which he has ever been portrayed as an antagonist. So in the 1983 arcade game Mario Brothers, Mario and his younger brother Luigi are portrayed as Italian-American plumbers who has to defeat creatures that have been coming from the sewers below New York. And that's a brief history of the games that led up to Super Mario Brothers, which is considered to be the mother of all platformer side-scrolling platforming games. So it may not be the first platform, but it's by far the most successful. And Shigeru Miyamoto worked together with Takashi Tezuka on this game. And they have worked together in the past with a game called Devil World back in 1984. So, and they still work together still to this day. So, after Mario Brothers, the next game for the team was the historical Super Mario Brothers, which I'm playing here today. So that was Miyamoto creating the overall primary concepts and designs, and Tezuka crafting them into reality. So the title brought together elements from all of Miyamoto's previous single game platformers, only instead of all the action happening on single screen, the game scrolled. So that opening up an entire world for the brothers to traverse. So, unlike the original Mario Brothers, the two siblings cannot play simultaneously. So Luigi, the second player, the green one, as all younger siblings know, they play it each level solo, so they are switching between levels. The game itself consists of 8 worlds, each broken into a series of levels, bonus rooms, and boss levels. The original goal of the game is for Mario to rescue Princess Toadstool, which she has been kidnapped by Bowser. And you all know Bowser, he's the big ass turtle or whatever, and his minion consists of both new and familiar enemies, and they basically are Copatropas, the turtles, the Copa Paratropas, that's the flying turtles, the Goombas, the Buzzy Beetles, the Hammer Brothers, Lakitu, Spiny, Piranha Plants, Cheep Cheep, Bullet Bill, Blooper, and Podobu. And if you don't know who Podobu is, you're not alone, because that's the jumping fireballs that comes towards you. So not many people know that. And to battle these enemies, Mario and Luigi depend on power-ups, and they get those by knocking off blocks or triggering the boxes and bricks that contains them. And these are the Power-Up Mushroom, which is an Alice in Wonderland reference that Mario grow his size twice. And the Fire Flower, everyone knows what that does. It makes Mario and Luigi shoot power fireballs out of their noses, or it looks like it at least. And Star, the Starman, and you all know what that does, it makes you invincible. But if you jump down a pit, you still die. And this is the sound that we all heard a lot the first time we played this game. So other items are the 1-Up Mushrooms and the coins. and the coins are gathered to gain extra points and bonus lives. So each level moves linearly from left to right and does not allow the player to backtrack. And the platform consists of landmasses, blocks, bricks, scaffolding, pipes and pipeworks, and various items that theme the world, such as pyramids, clouds, and the bottom of the sea. That's the underworld levels. And within each level, there are several hidden bonus areas, some are located beneath the surface and can only be accessed via pipes. And you don't know which pipes you can go down on, so I tried them all. And the clouds are accessed by leaping on jumping boards. And I, goddammit, I hate those jumping boards because I always timed them wrong and I did a freaking small jump and jumped down in a pit instead. And that's when I heard this sound. So, the game received a huge reception and became the must-play title of the console's generation. Nintendo began combining Super Mario Bros. And the cartridge with Duck Hunt and bundling it with the NES to help promote sales, and that basically worked out pretty well for them, because people would buy the NES just to play Super Mario Bros. Between its sales as a standalone game and bundled with the system, Super Mario Bros. Became the all-time best-selling video game for nearly 24 years. That's a long-ass time. And they sold a total of 40.241 million Nintendo versions worldwide, and that's a lot. Wii Sports broke this record in 2009, and they sold 60.67 million copies. Nintendo did it well back then. And my thoughts on the game is that this is one of the best games ever. I don't know how many times I tried to get to Bowser and I couldn't do it, and I heard this freaking sound all the time. If you haven't played this game, God forbid, I really suggest you do it, because it's a great game. So that's it from our first episode of Mario Mondays. Tune in next Monday for some more Mario action. Leave a like, leave a comment. If you have any questions, just write them down in the comment section below, and I will try to answer them as good as I can. So thanks a lot for watching, and as Mario would have said,
arrivederci!